Hello, Wonder Hussy here. Welcome to my very special holiday edition of Death Valley Life. Actually, we're getting ready to leave the desert and head on up to spend Christmas with our mom. And that means, well, we gotta load up the rig and get on the road early because, oh my gosh, it's gonna be a long drive. We got all our bags packed in the back of the car, and well, golly, it's not even 10 a.m. and I think we're just about ready to hit the road. Now, it's gonna be a really long, boring drive for most of it. Well, we're coming from Death Valley, so if you look at a map, we gotta first go down the road to Baker, California, home of the world's tallest thermometer. And then from there, well, unfortunately, we're gonna have to get on Interstate 15 and head on to Barstow. And then from Barstow, we're gonna head sort of northwest because we gotta cross the Sierra Nevada mountains. And so we're gonna cross over at the Tehachapi Pass, good old fashioned Tehachapi Pass. And that'll take us into Bakersfield. And then from Bakersfield, well, that's where it really gets boring. It's just a long straight drive up I-5. And if you've ever driven on I-5, oh, you know what I mean. All the way up, 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 up to the San Francisco Bay Area, where we will turn west towards the coast. And then we're gonna have to navigate the big city and cross over one of them bridges and head on up to my mom's place, which is in the Redwood Forest, even farther north of San Francisco. So I think the whole journey is something like 570 miles. It's probably gonna take about 9 or 10 hours. If we manage to leave here by 10, well, by gum, we orta sorta just at least get there in time for bed. Then take it out.
Rapid COVID test.
My sister got a rapid COVID test as a Christmas gift. And well, she figured she should probably take it because she has had the sniffles today. And before we get to my mom's, or our mom's, well, I guess it would be good to know for sure that she's not COVID positive. I'm pretty sure she isn't. But you know, now we're already like 2.5 hours into the journey. So if she takes this COVID test now and comes back positive, I mean, I guess we're just supposed to turn around. Let's find out what the test says. Do you know what gotas is? 3 to 4 gotas?
Oh, well, isn't that Portuguese?
Oh.
Yeah, this test kit came from a friend of ours who bought it in Portugal. So no, I'm not sure.
Gotas, I can Google it.
Drops, gotas is drops. So you stick the swab in your nose, you circle it around 5 times.
Does that look like I got it in and out?
Wait, so you have to check the color of the Q-tip and whatever? That looks like a pregnancy test.
1, 2, 3. I'll do 4 just cause.
Why not?
Okay, she put it in a bag and now we gotta wait 15 minutes for the results. We decided we might as well just keep driving because either way, if we have to turn around and drive all the way home, 15 more minutes isn't gonna make any difference.
Well, we made it about halfway. We're just outside Bakersfield, just drove through Bakersfield. My sister's COVID test obviously came back negative, so we're good to go. We're just gonna stop at Starbucks to grab some, well, I'm gonna get a fake coffee. She's gonna get a real coffee because we're gonna switch. She's gonna drive the second half. Brr.
I finally made it up to the soggy, damp redwood forest where my mom lives. Well, she lives in a cabin up the hill, but she happens to have this really cute, cozy little guest cabin down the hill. And well, that's where I'm gonna stay tonight. Now, my mom is a really private person, so she doesn't want any footage shot inside her house, but I'm pretty sure she's okay with me showing you the guest house, since I did shoot a video in here last summer. Look at that. What a cozy little cabin, huh? Wood-burning fireplace. There's a loft up there. Little kitchen. There's where I'm gonna be sleeping, on the couch. Got all my blankets piled up because it's cold in here. And look at the bathroom. Even the bathroom's cute. Little claw-footed bathtub. Anyway, my sister and I drove up here, well, actually 2 days ago. I shot GoPro footage for a while, but then it got dark and it was boring, so. Well, anyone who's ever driven up I-5 knows how boring it is anyway, so there really was no need to shoot much footage of that. But we got here, oh god, we had to stop at the grocery store too. We got here at like 8:30, I think, Wednesday night. So today's Friday, Christmas Eve, December 24th. Merry Christmas, everyone! Woohoo! So the first two nights that I was here, I slept up in the main house with my sister and my mom. But tonight, my brother and his girlfriend are coming too, and it's a small cabin. There's only one bathroom, not a lot of beds. I just thought, I'll come down here. There's this perfectly good guest cabin going to waste, so why not make use of it? And yeah, it's cold in here. I forgot, I meant to bring my little thermometer from the house to put it up and see. You know, in the past, I've always felt like it was so bone-chillingly dank and cold up here. I mean, you can probably see, looking out the window, I mean, this is the middle of a pretty dense redwood forest, and all the branches are covered in moss, and everything's dripping and wet and shady. So it's basically the polar opposite of where I live in Death Valley. But one of the similarities is it's cold both places. Golly, it's been so cold in Death Valley that being up here doesn't actually feel as cold. And I think that might have something to do with the fact that there's a lot of moisture in the air here. There's hardly any moisture in the air in Death Valley. It's very dry. And so I guess, I'm not sure if this is a proven theory or what, but like cold, dry cold seems like even colder than damp cold. I'm not sure that makes any sense, because damp cold, you know, you get really dank and moldy feeling and it just settles into your bones, but dry cold cuts through like a knife. And I speak from experience. I mean, well, if you've been watching my videos where I'm bundled up like a Russian babushka working in the on my laptop in the casita at our Death Valley compound. Well, I also bundle up like a Russian babushka here to work on my laptop. Matter of fact, that's what I did all day yesterday. But today, I am not dressed like a Russian babushka. Today I'm all dressed up in my new galoshes, some yoga pants, a festive Christmas red shirt, and my warmest puffer jacket, because I'm going to town. That's right, not only do I have to mail some thank you letters, but also, embarrassingly, yesterday morning I accidentally flushed my night guard down the toilet. I have to wear a night guard because I grind my teeth when I sleep. And well, that's why I had to have that tooth extracted and all that rigmarole with the metal implant put in and the friggin' crown. And you know, $3,000 later, I'm not trying to grind any more teeth, not trying to crack any more teeth. So, well, I normally wear this plastic mouth guard every night when I sleep. It's just like a, kind of looks like a retainer that you wear if you have braces. It fits over your, well, in my case, it fits over my top teeth. Like a clear plastic, like a boxer's mouth guard. Well, unfortunately, I think I had it tucked in the waistband of my pajamas when I got up, because I was gonna go rinse it off. You know, every morning after I sleep, I take it out and I brush my teeth and I brush out the mouth guard. Well, I think I forgot it was in the waistband of my pajamas when I sat on the toilet. And I'm pretty sure it must have fallen into the toilet and got flushed away, unfortunately. And it was $300. It was custom made by my dentist, which means I have to go back and spend another $300 to have a new one made. But obviously I won't be able to do that until I get back to, well, back to Death Valley, and then I have to drive all the way to Vegas to see the dentist. And I'm gonna be here for another 3-4 days. And so I thought, I better just go to the drugstore and buy one of those cheapy night guards, because at least it's better than nothing. make sure the door's firmly closed, and head on up the stairs to get in my rig and take the long journey to town. That's right, just like my sister and me, my mom lives way out in the country. Well, she lives way out in what I used to consider way out in the country. But now I think I know what way out in the country really means. I mean, if I was back home in Death Valley and had to go to the drugstore to get a night guard, it would be a 35-mile trip, and it would take about, half hour, 45 minutes. Here, I only have to drive 11 miles, and it's only supposed to take me about 15 minutes. I'm going to a place called Sebastopol, if you've ever heard of Sebastopol, California. Really weird, quirky, kind of little new agey hippie town. I picked the perfect time to do it because, man, it's just been pissing rain. Like, everything's been dripping. I mean, look, you can see this tree trunk behind me is just covered in moss. Everything here is damp and soggy and alive. And oh my God, my skin is loving it. My hair is loving it. My whole body is plump and hydrated. But pissing, pouring rain isn't that much fun to be driving around going to town in. So I'm glad I got this little sunny break here. It'll give me hopefully just enough time to make the 11-mile journey to the drugstore, get what I need, and then get back here into my pajamas. There's my rig waiting patiently for me in this damp, muddy environment. I mean, look at these puddles. Might as well try out my new galoshes. I got these for Christmas, and this seems like a good time to check and see if they work. Yep, my footsies are still warm and dry. Okay, enough tempting fate. Let me get in the car. Ugh, looks like it started raining again. Well, I better just hop in the drugstore real quick, mail my letters, and get out of here. Golly, $30. I mean, I'm gonna have to spend another $300 to get a real one made when I get back, but well, I guess this is cheaper than having another fake tooth put in. Okay, now I just gotta mail these thank you cards to all the people who sent me Christmas gifts, and then I'll be back home in my pajamas in no time. All right, back home to my pajamas. Whew, back in the forest. And now it's time to get cozy. There, back to my Russian babushka ways. All right, well, I'm gonna go back up to the main house and join my mom and sister and wait for my brother and his girlfriend to get here. And well, gosh, I don't really wanna annoy my family by vlogging our private family Christmas celebration. So here's some secret B-roll. Ugh, I gotta go for a walk. Ugh, even though it's pissing rain, I had to get out of the house or I felt like I'd never leave. Today is Sunday, Boxing Day, December 26th. I haven't left the house, really, since I got back from my drugstore run to Sebastopol. I hate to admit it, but I haven't really even changed out of my pajamas since then. So even though it's raining, I figured I might as well force myself to go out for a walk, because my sister and I are planning to drive back to the desert tomorrow. So this is pretty much my last chance to soak up the forest. And what a forest it is. I mean, look at this. Classic Northern California. Every tree is coated in a thick layer of juicy, damp moss. Anyway, even though my mom's cabin is super cozy, they got a fire going, everything's toasty, you hear the rain falling on the roof, it just makes you want to curl up and take a nap. Well, there's an unfortunate downside to all of that, and well, my mom actually calls it the vapors. Like the Victorians used to have the vapors. Well, her definition of vapors is this sort of foggy, misty feeling of sleepy, cozy, I don't want to do anything, sort of foggy headedness that, well, unfortunately kind of settles over you like a big, heavy, warm, furry blanket when you're up here in the wintertime. And oh my gosh, it makes it almost impossible to get anything done. That's what I mean by the vapors. So basically, I've been fighting a fierce case of the vapors for the last 3 days, and man, I had to break loose. So I decided to go for a walk through the beautiful forest just down the road from my mom's cabin and see what's going on in the wide, soggy world. Well, you can probably hear and maybe even see there's a waterfall coming down the hillside here, running right across the road. Fortunately, there's a little plank bridge here we can cross and not get swept away down canyon. Look how beautiful all this moss is. Oh my goodness. These ferns and this thick layer of wet leaves and humus. I think that's how you pronounce that. Anyway, I mean, look at this stuff. We don't have this where I come from. And even though my skin loves it, and even though my hair loves it, I'm not sure my spirit loves it. My spirit just wants to curl up on the couch in a fuzzy blanket by the fireplace and go to sleep forever. No! I can't give in to the forest! I can't give in to the vapors! I must fight my way back through these trees and this moss and these ferns, back to the dryness and the clarity of the desert. Back across the bridge of no return. Back down the path through the forest of gloom. Back to the coziness of my mom's cabin. At least for one more day. Well, I'm back in the desert. And what a difference! No trees, no moss, and no rain. At least not yet. Forecast says rain's coming tonight, and I believe it. There's fog and mist shrouding all these mountains all around our valley. It's pretty cool. I mean, look at how beautiful that is. With the setting sun lighting up the mountains. Oh my gosh. Amazing! But yeah, the irony is not lost on me that, well, I drove all the way up to visit my mom and it rained the entire time we were there. And then I drove all the way back down here to the sunny desert. And it's raining here too, or will be soon. And it's cold. I think this actually validates what I was saying earlier about how damp, dank, cold isn't quite as bad as this cutting dry desert cold. I mean, there's a wind going right now that's slicing right through all my clothes, and I am bundled up like a babushka again. That's my winter aesthetic. Desert babushka. Well, today I tried to get a little more colorful. Well, hold on, I'll show you.
It's my fancy Christmas babushka look. I'm wearing a Mexican poncho as a skirt. This is actually a poncho meant to wear around your neck, but I squeezed it up over my booty and I'm wearing it as a skirt instead. And then I've got my fancy Christmas boots on, so I really look like a Cossack. Anyway, babushka, Cossack, whatever you want to call it, I'm friggin' freezing, but I'm glad to be back in the wide open desert. I mean, I love the forest and I loved being in the forest and my skin loved being in the forest. But you know, there's just something to be said for wide open spaces and skies. You know, when you're in that forest, well, you can't even see the sky a lot of the time because you're covered in a beautiful canopy of green trees. And it was really nice to sort of marinate in that cozy canopy for a few days. But now, I'm happy to be back out in the open desert again. It's where I'm happiest. And it's where I'm gonna start this wonderful new year that we're all about to embark upon. 2022. Will it be better than 2021? I certainly hope so. And I have a really good feeling that it will. So I'm gonna wrap this video up now by wishing everybody who's watching a fantastic, healthy, peaceful, exciting, adventure-filled 2022. I'm not sure if it can be peaceful and adventure-filled, but I think it can. And I hope you all join me on many more adventures to come, because I've got some real doozies planned all over this beautiful desert and all over this beautiful country. Happy New Year, everyone!